II, some of the most horrific experiments were conducted from all sides of the conflict, most famously the German testing of Jewish people at concentration camps. German doctors were obsessed with conducting tests on people, such as surgery to make women have more twins, but that is for another story. Today, we are going to look at one of the most well-known and most feared experiments in history, the Russian sleep experiment. The Russians were trying to find new ways to better the troops and make them better fighters. One idea they came up with was a type of gas that would make soldiers devoid of sleep. They produced this gas and recruited prisoners for testing. 5 men were placed in a secure square room and given food for over a month, running water, toilet, books, and cots to sleep on. Oxygen intake valves were used to see if they were still alive, and microphones as well as inch-thick portholes were placed along the side of the sealed room. The gas would be administered via a vent, and the oxygen intake and microphones were constantly checked. If they accepted this experiment, they were promised their freedom and safe passage back to their homeland. If they did not, they would be immediately executed for crimes against humanity. They accepted. The experiment began, and the goal was to make it 30 days without having to sleep. For the first 5 days, everything was going fine. All 5 German prisoners began to tell each other stories about their traumatic childhoods and the circumstances that led to their capture. They also began to develop severe paranoia. They then stopped talking to each other and began to whisper into the microphones and portholes. They were attempting to win over the trust of the scientists by turning over their comrades. The Russians suspected this was a result of the gas itself because the behavior was so abnormal. After 9 days, one of the test subjects started screaming. He ran the length of the chamber over and over, screaming as loud as he could. He continued to scream for 3 hours straight. The subject then laid on the floor, and he could no longer scream, but give silent squeaks. The subject had physically torn his vocal cords, but the weird thing about the situation is that the other captives didn't react to it. It was like nothing ever happened. Then the second of the captives began to scream. They then took books and ripped pages out and smeared it with their own feces and pasted it all over the portholes. After that, the screaming stopped, as well as the whispering into the microphones. 3 more days passed, and there was no sound coming from the chambers, so the Russians kept checking the mics to see if they were working. They thought it impossible that no sound could be coming from the test chamber with 5 captives in it. They checked the oxygen consumption and indicated that all 5 men were still alive. More oxygen was being consumed because some prisoners were strenuously exercising. The 14th day arrived, and the Russians used the intercom to attempt to provoke action from the captives. They said they wouldn't do it, but they tried anyway. They announced, "We are opening the chamber to test the microphones. Step away from the door and lie flat on the floor or you will be shot. Compliance will earn one of you your immediate freedom." They heard nothing, and then a calm voice said, "We no longer wish to be freed." The scientists began to argue what they should do since they were not able to provoke any more reactions from the captives. They decided to open the door on midnight of the 15th day. The researchers then flooded the chamber with fresh air, and the captives immediately began to object. They were crying and begging for the gas to be turned back on. That is all they wanted. They began to scream, way louder than before. Soldiers rushed into the chamber, and what they saw will scar them for the rest of their lives. The soldiers began to scream as well. 4 of the 5 subjects were still alive. Rations for the last 5 days had not been touched. There were massive chunks of meat from the thighs and chest stuffed into the drain in the center, causing 4 inches of liquid to accumulate on the floor. They could not tell how much of the liquid was actually blood among other liquids. The remaining test subjects had large portions of flesh torn from all over their bodies. Among later examination, they found that the wounds had been inflicted by hand, not by teeth as they thought. Muscles had been torn from the ribs, exposing the subject's rib cage and lungs. The digestive tract could be seen working as it attempted to digest the subject's own flesh they had been eating for days. Many soldiers refused to return to the chamber to remove the captives. The test subjects continued to scream to be left in the chamber and for the gas to be turned on. The process of getting the subjects out were brutal. Some of the soldiers died from getting their throats ripped, as well as others being gravely injured by the subjects biting. One of the test subjects was fighting like a cornered animal, and the researchers tried to sedate him but proved impossible. He was injected with 10 times the human dose of morphine and the captive still fought. He continued to scream but soon bled out from a ruptured spleen. The rest of the three captives were taken to the medical facility, and the ones that could speak continued to beg to be put back into the gas. The most injured of the three were taken to surgery and prepped for the operation. The doctors brought anesthetics and put him under. His muscles were badly torn and broken 9 bones in the struggle in the chamber. The second survivor of the group was the first to start screaming, and with his vocal cords destroyed, he was unable to object to the surgery. He was only able to violently shake his head. They brought anesthetic gas near him and he violently shook his head. They attempted the surgery without it. The Russians were astonished at what they had done. The remaining subjects that survived surgery were put back into the chamber until the Russians knew what to do with the situation. They had little resistance but were glad to finally be back inside the gas. Among the many experiments that went on in World War II, this proves to be one of the most brutal. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to hit the subscribe button and hit the bell beside it and select the box. This way you'll be notified for any new videos. Thank you for watching.